Hello everyone, Xenomom here. Welcome back to Minecraft for Parents and part 2 of my Minecraft Parental Control Guide. In the last video, we covered how to create and link Microsoft accounts, as well as walked through the basics of the Microsoft Family Safety Dashboard. If these are things that you need help with, make sure you go back and watch that video first. You'll also need a Microsoft Family account in order to get the most out of the things we're talking about today, which include Xbox profile settings, in-game safety tools, and device-specific options that let you tailor your child's experience even more. Once your Microsoft Family is set up and your accounts are linked, head over to account.xbox.com/settings. The link is in the description. This is where some of the most important Minecraft permissions live. For reference, Microsoft and Xbox are now integrated, which means that a Microsoft account is essentially also an Xbox account. In fact, you should be able to log into the Xbox website with your Microsoft account information. Enter the email address associated with your Microsoft account and click Next. Then click Send Code, retrieve the code, and enter it as indicated. Once logged in, here's how to change your child's settings. First, click on your gamer tag in the top right. Then click the ellipses, or three dots, and select Xbox Settings. Here, you can see your child's profile next to your own. Click on their profile, and you'll be able to change settings under three main categories: privacy, Xbox and Windows 10 online safety, and message safety. Obviously, everyone has different preferences, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time going over each of these things in detail. But now that you know where all of this exists, you can come back and establish the settings that work for you and your family. There are a few things that I want to touch on, and those include: under privacy, you may want to adjust a few communication allowances. Specifically, allowing the use of video communications. This option allows or disallows the use of video to communicate while playing on Xbox. You may also want to consider adjusting the communication outside of Xbox with voice and text option. This allows or blocks voice and text communication with people on gaming services outside of Xbox, like on PCs and PlayStation. Another one to look at is others can communicate with voice, text, or invites. This determines who your child can communicate with on Xbox using voice and text, as well as who may send them invitations to parties, games, and clubs. Select allow, friends, or block completely according to your preferences. A couple other settings on this tab that you may want to change include others can see if you're online, and others can see your Xbox profile details. Once you've selected your preferences for these items, scroll all the way down and click Submit in order to save them. There's also a few things you may want to change in the Xbox and Windows 10 Devices Online Safety tab. Specifically, the You Can Join Cross-Network Play option. This allows or blocks multiplayer gaming with players on other gaming services outside of Xbox. Also, the You Can Join Multiplayer Games option. This determines if your child can join multiplayer games at all, as well as the You Can Add Friends and Follow Others option, which you've probably already guessed allows or blocks adding friends and following others. Again, once you've selected your preferences for these items, scroll all the way down and click Submit to save them. The Message Safety tab mostly deals with how much filtering you want when messaging is turned on. It's definitely something worth looking at if you want to allow communication between players, but don't want your child exposed to mature or offensive language. This pretty much covers the basics of the privacy and online safety options provided on the Xbox website, but don't go anywhere. There's still a lot of things that you can do to improve the safety of your child's gameplay. For Minecraft Bedrock Edition, some important settings exist inside the game itself. It can be a good idea to combine these settings with Microsoft and Xbox's online controls for extra protection and enhanced gameplay. To access these, open Minecraft Bedrock and click Settings. In the accessibility settings, you can turn on text-to-speech options or disable your child's ability to open chat messages altogether. You can also customize how chat appears, as well as adjust various visuals like the darkness effect and glint strength. In general settings, you can also turn on or off the in-game tutorial, which provides basic hints as your child plays, as well as only allow trusted skins, and filter profanity. Basically, when this setting is toggled on, a text filter is applied to everything your child sees. Now, you may be asking yourself, can't my child just access and change these settings back themselves? And technically, yes, they can. Most in-game settings are not password protected, which means that they can be adjusted by children when they're playing. That's why it's a good idea to make the in-game settings in conjunction with the Microsoft Family and Xbox settings that we've already discussed. Changes made there can't be overridden from inside the game. It's also worth mentioning that Minecraft Java Edition is a little bit different. Java is the original PC version of Minecraft, and it doesn't come with the same built-in parental controls that Bedrock has. Both games do, however, have an in-game safety tool that Mojang introduced in version 1.19.1, the Player Reporting System. But how does it actually work? When playing, simply press Escape to open Minecraft's Pause menu. Then select Player Reporting. Here, you'll see a list of all of the players on the server, with two buttons next to each name. The chat bubble icon can be used to block all of that player's messages, although they'll still be visible to others, just not your child. The yellow warning symbol, however, allows you to report messages you feel may be abusive or dangerous. You can also report inappropriate player skins and player names. If reporting does become necessary, you or your child will have to select the specific messages, choose a report category, like hate speech or harassment, and then leave a short comment. Mojang moderators will then review the report, even if it's from a private server. That said, this tool is only helpful after something has happened. While it's useful, it does not replace parental controls. It's also worth noting that many platforms offer extra parental controls that go beyond what Microsoft, Xbox, and Minecraft provide. These are particularly helpful if your child plays on console or a mobile device. Specifically, Nintendo Switch provides a Nintendo Switch Parental Controls app, which can be used to set playtime limits, restrict online features, and block chat. PlayStation 5 has a family management tool under the PlayStation Settings, which can control communication, spending, and multiplayer access. And Chromebook and Android both provide a Google Family link, which can be used to manage screen time, app access, and more. It's important to realize that these work in addition to the safety controls that we've already discussed. So consider using them all together for best results. I know that that was a lot of information, but hopefully now you feel a lot more confident in your ability to manage your child's gameplay. With the right tools and a little bit of guidance, Minecraft can be an incredibly safe and rewarding experience for your child. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe for future Minecraft for Parents content. And, as always, happy gaming!